Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praise be Jesus Christ. Greetings and welcome to you all to this live broadcast coming to you from St. Peter's Square for the midday Angelus prayer on this Wednesday, November 1st, the Solemnity of All Saints. Pope Francis, in just a few moments, will be appearing from that window our television viewers are seeing right now. We're zooming out from the Apostolic Palace there. And we have pilgrims gathered throughout the square, visitors in Rome. It's a holiday throughout Italy, as among other nations. And in fact, the Wednesday general audience that usually takes place did not take place this morning. Instead, Pope Francis will be leading the recitation of the Angelus prayer in the square. It's a cloudy day here. The weather's cooled down after many months of a extraordinarily warm summer and fall as well. It's also been a very, very busy time leading up to these days. On Sunday, the month-long synod drew to a close with the closing mass. It's the first session. The next session will be in a year's time. And Pope Francis as well at the Angelus on Sunday remembered the dramatic and terrible situation in the Mideast, calling for a ceasefire in the Holy Land and addressing the pilgrims gathered in the square there this past Sunday. The Pope invited everyone to continue to pray for the very serious situation in Palestine and Israel, and in particular he asked that humanitarian aid be allowed to enter Gaza and that all the hostages there be freed. This is this past Sunday. Today, on this November 1st, the Pope will be greeting many people gathered in the square there who, again, are visiting Rome on this national holiday. And he has a busy schedule as well. Tomorrow, he'll be leading and celebrating Mass on All Souls Day, the commemoration of all the faithful departed at the Commonwealth War Cemetery, the Rome War Cemetery that is just inside here in the city of Rome. He'll be celebrating that Mass there tomorrow, and then on November 3rd as well. He has a busy day. He'll celebrate Mass at 11 o'clock on that Friday, remembering Pope Benedict the 16th and all the cardinals and bishops who've died throughout the year. And that's on November 3rd. We'll be broadcasting, of course, those celebrations live here on Vatican News, on YouTube, where you might be watching this live or watching it on demand after this live broadcast, as well as on our Facebook live stream, or via, of course, our television partners who are broadcasting here, including Catholic Television, Catholic Faith Network, Shalom World Television Networks USA, Salt and Light Television, EWTN Television, Shalom Television India, Atma Darshan Television India, Uganda Catholic Television, and our radio partners, Radio Maria England and Luminous Radio India. Our radio and television partners there joining us here, as well as all of you watching via other television networks, maybe live via our satellite feed or our rebroadcast on other television channels and radio networks as well. And for our television viewers, you, our radio listeners, of course, we're zooming into the Apostolic Palace with the video images here. And Pope Francis has just appeared at that window there, to the applause of those below.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, buongiorno.
Dear brothers and sisters, good morning.
E buona festa.
And happy feast.
Celebriamo oggi.
Today we celebrate the Solemnity of All Saints. In the light of this feast day, let's focus for a few minutes on holiness, and in particular on two of its characteristics. It's a gift. It's a gift, you can't buy it. And at the same time, it's a journey, a gift and a journey. First of all, it's a gift. Holiness is a gift of God, which we've received at baptism. And if we let it grow, it can completely change our lives. So the saints are not heroes who are unreachable or distant. They're people like us, our friends, whose starting point is the same gift that we've received, baptism. Indeed, if we think about it, we've certainly met some of them, some saints, daily saints, good people who people are living their Christian vocation with seriousness and simplicity, what I like to call the saints next door, who are just living normal lives. Holiness is a gift offered to everyone for a happy life. And after all, when we receive a gift, what's our first reaction? It's precisely that we're happy, because it means that someone loves us. The gift of holiness makes us happy. It shows us how God loves us. But every gift must be accepted, welcomed, and it carries with it a responsibility of a response. We say thank you, but how do we respond to this thank you? It's an invitation to commit ourselves so that it's not a gift that's squandered. In fact, the saints have received the same gift that we've received. And so with this we come to the second point, that the holiness is a journey to be made together, helping each other, united with those great companions who are the saints. There are elder brothers and sisters on whom we can always count. The saints support us. And when we take a wrong turn along the way, with their silent presence, they never fail to correct us. There are sincere friends on whom we can trust. We can trust them because they desire our well-being. And in their lives, we find an example. In their prayers, we receive help. And in communion with them, we are bound in a bond of brotherly love. So holiness is a gift and a journey. So we can ask ourselves, do I remember having received the gift of the Holy Spirit, who calls me to holiness and helps me to arrive there? Do I thank the Holy Spirit for this gift? Do I feel that the saints are close to me? Do I turn to them? Do I know the history of some of them? It's good for us to know the lives of the saints and to be moved by their examples, their witness. And it does us a great deal of good to turn to them in prayer. May Mary, Queen of all Saints, help us feel the joy of the gift received and increase in us the desire for our eternal destination.
Ave Maria, gracia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Santa Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre, amen.
Ecce ancilla Domini.
Fiat mi secundum verbum tuum.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre, amen.
Et verbum caro factum est.
Et habitavit in nobis.
Ave Maria, gratia plena, Dominus tecum, benedicta tui mulieribus, et benedictus fructus ventris tui, Iesus.
Sancta Maria, Mater Dei, ora pro nobis peccatoribus, nunc et in hora mortis nostre, amen.
Ora pro nobis, Santa Dei Genitris.
Ut indigni efficiamur promissionibus Christi.
Gratiam tuam, quesum Domine, mentibus nostris infunde, che angelo nunziante, Christi fili tui, incarnazione coniovim, per passionem eius et crucem, a resurrezione gloriam perducamur, per Christum Dominum nostrum.
Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Gloria Patri et Filio et Spiritui Sancto.
Sicut erat in principio et nunc et semper et in saecula saeculorum. Amen.
Pro fidelibus defuntis, regim aeternam dona eis Domine.
Et in lux perpetua luce Dei.
Requiescant in pace.
Amen.
Sit nomen Domini benedictum.
Exoc nunc et usque in saeculum.
Aiutorium nostrum in nomine Domini.
Qui fecit caelum et terram.
Benedicat vos, omnipotens Deus, Pater, et Filius, et Spiritus Sanctus. Amen. Amen.
Pope Francis giving his apostolic blessing there to all in the square, all those listening and watching. Dear brothers and sisters, I greet with affection all of you, pilgrims from various countries, families, parish groups, associations, school groups, and especially the faithful from Allenbach in Germany. And Monterrey, Mexico there, Pope Francis waving. And students from Denmark. And the Italian police group present in the square. And a special greeting to those taking part in the marathon, the All Saints Marathon. That takes place each year on this day. Thank you for this beautiful initiative of Italy's Don Bosco Mission Foundation. Tomorrow afternoon, I'll be celebrating Mass at the Commonwealth War Cemetery here in Rome from the Second World War, those buried there. And let's continue to pray for all those suffering from the wars of today. We remember suffering Ukraine, suffering Palestine, suffering Israel. Let's remember all the other parts of the world where war is happening. And I wish you all a very good feast on this All Saints Day. And please remember to pray for me. And have a good lunch and arrivederci. Pope Francis waving there to the crowds as he traditionally does. The camera zoomed in there for our radio listeners there. He's greeting as he usually does before he leaves the window there. And we're seeing the crowds in St. Peter's Square. Pope Francis again asking for prayers for all those suffering from war around the world. And while mentioning Ukraine, Palestine, Israel, the Pope asked us to remember all those in other parts of the world where, unfortunately, war is ravaging and people are suffering, to remember them in our prayers, which we'll do in a special way tomorrow as well on the commemoration of all the faithful departed, All Souls Day, where he'll celebrate Mass there at the Rome War Cemetery, and remembering all those who've been affected by war, and we pray for peace. Thank you all for joining us for our live broadcast here. We'll, again, as you just heard, be on the air again tomorrow and the following day as well with our special broadcast. You can go to vaticannews.va for the full update on all. My thanks for the tech help there to Adriano Vitali and Father Felipe Herrera for producing this broadcast. A blessed Sunday to you all. Laudetur Jesus Christus. Praised be Jesus Christ.